The Jewish holiday of Passover begins tomorrow. It commemorates the exodus of the Jewish people from slavery in Egypt. It's one of the most important celebrations on the calendar. Rabbi Mendel Alperowitz is founder and director of the Chabad Jewish Center of South Dakota. Welcome back to In the Moment. You're back in the studio, Rabbi. Thanks for being here.
Thank you, Laurie. Thank you for having me. It's always great to be back.
Remind people who haven't heard you on the show for a while what your role is with the Jewish community in South Dakota as a rabbi.
Well, thank you. South Dakota has a very beautiful Jewish community, and I'm honored to be a rabbi living here in South Dakota, the first and only rabbi to live here in some 40 years, and it's the greatest privilege my wife and I could have.
You're still here, which means you have found, and we've talked before about anti-Semitism, we've talked before about the weather, which is challenging, and have you found a community that you feel, have you found a place that you feel you can raise a family and do the work that you want to be doing in the world?
Absolutely. There's no better place we could live, my wife and I, and raise our children than right here in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Everywhere I go across the state, I'm welcomed, embraced, and it's just a real, real special place to be.
A lot of what you do is education of the non-Jewish community as well. Tell us a little bit about Passover. How do you explain it to people who are coming at it for the very first time?
Passover is probably the most well-known and one of the most special Jewish holidays that we have. We've been celebrating it now for 3,335 years. It goes back all the way to the days when the Jewish people were slaves to Pharaoh in Egypt. After several hundred years of being slaves in Egypt, God took the people of Israel out of Egypt through the desert on their way to the Promised Land. And it's the story of that exodus, becoming a free people, leaving the slavery, the bondage, and going out to become a free people that we celebrate every year since then. And we celebrate it with the Passover holiday. So for 8 days, we refrain from eating any bread or leavened bread, any food item that rises. And that is to commemorate the special bread that our ancestors, the Israelites, ate as they left Egypt. They left so fast, they rushed out, that the bread that they were preparing didn't have time to rise. They just ran out with it, and it baked on their backs. So to remember that miracle and leaving Egypt so quickly, we eat a very, very thin bread on Passover known as matzah. It's more like a hard cracker than a bread. And then we gather on the first two evenings of the holiday for what's known as the Passover Seder. That's a big dinner with, it's a service and a dinner combined. And we do different things at that evening to commemorate the slavery and to thank God for our freedom.
What's happening in your heart as some of the rituals are played out again and again, knowing these are centuries-old rituals, and yet they might have a message not only for these people long ago, but for what's happening in your lives and the lives of Jews around the world right now? What are some of the things that you prepare your heart to receive?
So one of the things that we do, we dip something, a potato, a vegetable, a parsley, or an onion, into a little bit of salt water. And that is, the salt water is there to remind us of the tears that our ancestors cried during their slavery. And we do that to remember that, but then immediately afterwards and throughout the evening, it's really a night of celebration, of thanksgiving, giving and appreciating the blessings that we have today to be free, and remembering that time long ago when we were not, but celebrating today that freedom and really trying to pass that down to our children as well, that we're a free people. God took us out. He made us a free people. And one of the questions that is always asked at the Seder is known for the four questions. The children ask the four questions. Why is this night different than all other nights? Why are we doing all these different rituals? And for many people, I think, especially in South Dakota, that question can sometimes be, why am I different than everybody else? Why am I a Jew? What is there about me and this? And we answer, because many years ago, your ancestors were slaves in Egypt and God took you out and made you a free people. And that's why we celebrate this evening and have all these special rituals.
Mm. for people who are not in this tradition but want to be supportive of their Jewish neighbors? Are there things people say to you? Are there things that an employer can make room for a Jewish employee who wants to honor Passover? What are some of the ways that people interact in a community like South Dakota, you know, and not just Sioux Falls, the state and many rural towns across the state to show their support and love?
Just simply wishing people a happy Passover. If you know that your friend, your neighbor, your colleague is Jewish, if you wish them a happy Passover, that's a very meaningful thing. It's very nice. And I've certainly experienced that sort of embrace and welcomeness from people across the state. They know there's a Jewish holiday coming up, or they could see that I'm Jewish. They want to wish me something, and that's very beautiful. That's very, very meaningful.
Yeah. Tell me about any public events that you might be having.
So the Rebbe, Rabbi Menachem Schneerson, greatly encouraged that as many Jewish people as possible be able to have matzah on Passover and be able to participate in a kosher Passover Seder. So for me, as the only rabbi living in South Dakota, I feel that responsibility to do everything I can to make sure every Jewish person has matzah and also a Seder to attend. So we're hosting a very big Seder tomorrow evening, and for the last few weeks we've been making sure that as many people as possible can have matzah for this holiday.
What does that mean for people who have not been before?
It's a great celebration. It's a service and a dinner combined. We go through, we read the Haggadah. This is a book that has been used at the Seder dinner for hundreds or thousands of years. The different prayers, the different verses, talking about the slavery, talking about the freedom that we have. And a key part of the Seder is education, teaching our children, passing on to them these rituals that we have, the understanding of our faith. What does it mean to be a Jew? Why am I a Jew? What is this? And we try to teach and explain. And the way we actually teach, and this is what we learn from the Seder, is not by lecturing, not by telling our children, but having them ask the questions. They come to the dinner, to the Passover Seder service, and really the children are the center of attention. The children ask us, why is this night different? What is this about? Why do we do this? And we try to give them the answers as best as we can, because ultimately that is really the best way for education.
So in our remaining minute, do you remember being a child and being the questioner? And is there a time when you switch to being the answerer? Like, when does that happen for you?
We still ask those questions.
Okay.
Even as an adult, you ask the question. So long as your parents are alive, you ask your parents. And when your parents are not alive, you ask your Father in heaven.
Rabbi Mendel Alperowitz, thank you so much for being here with us. It is always a pleasure and delight. Happy Passover.
Thank you, Laurie.